That one?
Yeah.
So you guys, this is my outfit for CraveCon. I think I showed you before, but this is the back of the shirt. I got the Mario suit. You see my socks. Mario socks. So we're gonna go. We're on our way right now. It is 9 o'clock from Houston. It takes about an hour to get there, so we're on our way over. Okay, guys, we just got here at CraveCon. Like nobody's here, but anyways, this is we're not there yet. But this is like the first CraveCon ever. It's 2016, right, Deidre?
Yeah.
This is the first CraveCon here at Galveston. So you said go up the escalator? Let's walk them up. Let's walk up the escalator so we can go there faster.
I'm tired and you sound like
oh. There's still nobody. Look, I see a picture of Dame Drops. Dude, hold on. I want to get a picture of the beach real fast. Look at that. This is Galveston, Texas. There's Dame right there. There's Dame Drops right there. Hello.
Hey, how's it
going? Good, how are you doing?
Good.
I did the tickets here. I give you the receipt thing.
That works.
Okay. Registration thing. How you doing?
Good. You're gonna have your two drink coupons for the after party in your bag. You're gonna have your dinner bracelet and your after party bracelet in your bag, so make sure you hold on tight to your bag, okay?
Don't lose it. I'll put them on so I won't lose it.
Lose it, right. I understand, but don't lose those drink tickets either.
Okay, thank you.
Is that like a
It's on the
screen. Oh, okay.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Where's Dame? I just saw Dame right now. Look how like nobody's here. Oh, get this. Didn't get the schedule? Huh? Hello.
I saw Dame.
Yeah, it is.
I'm trying to get it all
done
on all my social media
and
make my
visa. How you doing, Ken?
Good,
you're well, I texted you like you're in there. YouTube Jared.
What?
I like YouTube Jared.
YouTube Jared, how are you, sir?
Good.
This says Jared right there.
Yeah, this is from when I took her, me and her went to California. We were in, we just came out on the 20th. What was it? Let's make a deal.
He doesn't care about that.
No, he's really chill, though. He's cool.
Cool.
But yeah.
Oh, yeah, he was telling me about you. Was he, what, the one you were saying has the most
what?
Subscribers?
He's got 600,000. I've got about 340,000.
He has two.
I have like
two subscribers?
No, I got like 3,000.
That's awesome.
He
not
paid
a lot.
For them though. Does that count?
I paid for a lot of them, but I don't pay for.
No, I don't do that again.
No, I stopped doing it. Okay, I stopped doing it. But like when I first started, I didn't know better. Like so I did, but now I don't. Like.
I told you don't do that again. But it's about the content.
That's right. When people can see that, through that, because they say, 3,000 subscribers, but you put out a video, you only get 2 views.
Yeah.
Right? They say something's wrong, like something doesn't jive.
Yeah,
right?
That's what they still tell me, and they're like, well, why is it you have so many subscribers and you have a lot of views? I'm like, oh, I don't know. I think I messed up. Yeah.
Don't tell tell anybody after me.
Yeah, no, no.
No, I told.
Oh, don't tell.
He wasn't going to tell.
But yeah, I watched all your videos. I saw, you know, the one where you and your son went to the hospital because he was sick. You know?
Yeah, his lung collapsed. And he's doing fine now. We're supposed to go to Hawaii. So we had to cancel our whole Hawaii trip, which was going to be like this one, kind of our, I don't know, one of those big family adventure things, right?
Oh, yeah.
We're thinking, you know, my daughter's 19 now, my son's 16. Eventually they're going to start going to university, not going to be around much, so we wanted to have like a big family to do. We've always wanted to go to Hawaii as a family, so but we couldn't go, so we changed our plans and we went to Newfoundland. So we drove across Canada to Newfoundland where Ben's girlfriend was.
It's really neat out there.
That's beautiful.
Yeah. What's up? How you doing, man? How you doing? That's Kyle.
Yeah, I met them.
Kyle.
Yeah, he got the...
Yeah, he was showing pictures of that he took with you. Like, is this Tri Scott? How you doing, man?
Hi.
Actually, he had found my channel, and then he told him about it, and then they were like, ah.
That's so awesome.
Well, he's here because you guys inspire him.
Yeah, he inspired me like a ton. Like, I do like a lot. I try to make my videos as much as possible. Like,
just keep working.
Yeah.
Keep working hard.
Where are you guys going?
We're just walking around. Trying to find the
other person. Oh, okay. Have you seen Boogie Night 2988?
He was just out here. He walked back in.
Probably behind the thing. You got a plush, so you can go back.
I bought him some because I saw he was doing the Pokemon. I'm sorry.
Oh, it looked like your camera was off, but your finger was over the line.
But you know what? It was off the whole time.
Oh.
And then because when you start talking about like Hawaii or something about that, and then I turned it on.
Oh.
So anyways, these are Tri Squad, and then Kyle. Who's that?
He's part of the Tri Squad.
Oh, part of the Tri Squad. Okay. I'll just check in.
Tri Squad.
Okay, cool. And Ken Domeek, man.
Are
awesome.
You gonna speak later?
I want to get a picture with him.
Oh yeah.
For my Instagram. And I want to get a picture with you guys from my Instagram, if that's okay. With my phone too, with your phone and my phone too.
I like what you're wearing.
Oh, thanks.
It's a burger. She's wearing a burger.
Okay.
Okay, ready? Awesome.
Okay, I want you to do another picture with this phone.
Can I see that?
Yeah. It's kind of, it's not a GoPro, but it's an action cam, but it's like, it works.
Oh, okay.
Can I get a selfie with you really?
Sure. Here you go, here comes your camera.
Oh, thanks, bro. Okay, so I want to do a picture on this crappy phone.
You want to do a selfie or a picture?
A picture, I'm sorry.
Okay. You're wasting on.
No, he's chill, man. You just be talking to someone else. Everyone talking to me, right?
No, he was talking to
me. Take a couple of them.
Cut this one.
First grade.
So you got them? You got it?
It'll be the one to remember, right?
Yeah,
exactly. These are for my Instagram.
No, it's funny. Even Matthew Satoro was saying, you know, he went to the second one, right? And that's his memory of VidCon.
Oh, VidCon.
Right. But he wishes he went to the first one, right? Mm-hmm.
Cool. Cool. That's my Instagram. Oh, my Instagram. Yeah.
And are y'all going to be, like, recording for your channel, too, throughout?
Oh. I like you have a bite in it.
Yeah. We got the special ones.
Oh, cool, man.
I have the foodie one. So, he sponsored me, though. I wouldn't have come if
I paid for a ticket.
Awesome.
So he's thanks a good brother.
That. Yeah.
And this is like, he inspires me and y'all inspire me.
Yeah, because he has a travel channel. And we'll
do well.
Social Blade.
We'll do well.
Social Blade had depicted it as a travel channel, and I said, dude, because she went to the Winter Place and she wasn't recording.
But I don't record
at all.
Like I get caught up too much in the morning. I used to have a videographer, and that was nice because he would like
for sure, yeah.
Record and edit all my next.
I record all my own stuff, like right now.
But you do it on your phone, and it doesn't look
good. Yeah, man, I was so glad to see you, though, bro.
Like,
I've been watching you since like 2013, man.
Thank you.
2013.
I woke up this morning. I was like, well, here we go. Well, here we go.
Yeah.
Because this is like just all out of Dame in my pocket right now.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
We're hoping it's successful.
It is, I know it's going to be. I know
it is successful. Financially successful.
Yeah.
That's what I also need it to be because I need to at least break even.
Yeah.
Would be nice. I don't mind breaking even.
Yeah.
I just don't want to lose money.
No, yeah, me neither. I'm about money.
Yeah. It's all about.
Okay, I'm like, it has to be.
Yeah.
So it ends
I have to go talk to Dane.
Okay.
We'll see you again.
All right, we'll see you. We're going to get some more people on here. Okay, where'd that guy go?
Can you sign my Oreo bag?
Yeah, for sure,
Dane,
man. Yeah, I was telling Ken and Dane, like, we should get, like, Joey's World Tour, everybody together, and do, like, a huge food review. You know what I'm saying? You like my socks? Look, they got Mario. Okay, so where do you want me to sign?
Anywhere.
Where are you? Thanks, bro. But yeah, I was saying, like,
a picture with you guys?
Yeah, for Instagram. Okay,
hold up to your autograph.
Dieter, get in.
No, I
okay, so I want to do Colt Move. Colt Move's over here. How you doing, bros? How you doing? Colt Move. Colt Move. You don't mind if I do like Instagram picture?
Yeah, I'll go for it, man.
Cool, man.
$5. Yeah.
$5. I have like 3 cents. So okay, yeah. Let me. Okay, do it with that phone, and then I want
picture.
You to do it. Yeah, picture, and then I want you to do it with
the
other phone.
$5 for each.
I'm getting my thing back.
Oh, you want to get in the middle?
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
There you go.
All right. And then another picture with this. Another picture.
That's another $5. Y'all should do that. You'll make a lot of money.
And one with this.
One. Only one.
Okay, so like, I want it sideways like that. You couldn't get a couple of them?
I got like three on you. Honestly.
Oh, but you can send them. Oh, this is not bad. Okay.
He's an Oompa Loompa today.
Yeah, I did my eyebrows and I'm like, oh, I'm like an Oompa Loompa.
Do a thing. The
Oompa Loompa Loompa Dee Doo. I've got another riddle for you. What do you get when you go to CraveCon?
It's your guys' first time at Galveston?
Yeah.
This is my first time at any con.
Oh, really?
Believe it or not. Yeah.
There's like, actually a couple CraveCon. People I've heard that from.
Yeah, like, I'm only going to go to CraveCon. Like, this is my comfort zone. The kitchen. The kitchen is my comfort zone.
I think that's the plan is, Ken was saying something about, like, they're going to try to do satellite things, so they'll have, like, a dinner get-together, like, say, like, a New York.
Okay. I know, I always see you there.
Like, LA,
you're like,
so try to kind of
like, making up kind of crazy stuff.
That's awesome.
Bring it here to Galveston.
Yeah, yesterday I made like the nachos fully loaded, and I tried it, and then my wife was like, I want to Hulk smash these nachos, and I'm like, not inside, no, I don't want to check roaches or anything, so I'll take it outside. So you guys like, ah! She started punching the nachos loaded.
YouTube videos are inspiring.
Well, I do all kind of random stuff too. I'm like so random too. But yeah. Have you seen Boogie Tuna
888? Yeah, I think he's in the VIP.
I bought him some Pokemon, like this is for the online Pokemon game.
Oh.
Okay.
Yeah, he's back there if you want to go.
Okay, yeah, let me go back there and just get him on video real quick. All right, guys. I'll see you in a bit. Like there's not a lot of people, so we can hang out and chill or whatever.
Yeah, sounds good, man. Good meeting you.
You too. You can't go back. You can't go back there. I'm VIP.
I can't go back there.
Yeah, I'm just gonna do it real fast. I gotta get some.
Can you get this sign by Boogie Tuna when you go in there?
Boogie Tuna?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Where do I sit?
Huh?
I'm gonna wait here.
Okay, yeah, I'll be right back. So.
That's where he was gonna get there.
Are you just open back
here?
Yeah. Okay. Hello, how are you doing?
Yeah, I mean,
Boogie.
What's up, man?
We have so many people there. What's up? Watching, and I've been watching the whole series.
How you doing? You
took
care.
Oh, yeah, of course, man.
One of my subscribers wanted to ask, well, he asked me if you could sign this.
Absolutely. Hell yeah.
Was this from the review they did just a minute ago?
I'm not sure. Oh, but I opened up some packs of Pokemon cards yesterday. And I really don't use these, you know, for the online Pokemon game.
Oh, awesome, man.
I want to give them to you.
Thank you for that. Awesome, dude.
Does that look good? Yeah, yeah.
Hell yeah. Thank you for that, man.
Yeah, because I usually give them to my subscribers, but then I was like,
I'm so addicted to that game.
The online one?
Yeah.
Are you serious? I open like 6 packs a day, and I don't use them. Like, I fill them away.
Whatever you want, send them to me.
Yeah, definitely, man.
I'm addicted to that game, dude.
What anime came out?
Definitely, yeah.
I'm not even using my physical cards, you know. I'm hoarding them.
Yeah.
For the unboxings or whatever.
Yeah, I saw the video. That's why I thought about you.
Thank you, man.
But yeah, my name is YouTube Jared. Let me see him. But let me see if I get. I was supposed to bring more cards, but I only brought a few of my cards. Let me put this down over here.
Oh crap!
Story was incredible.
What was his name? Griffin.
Oh my god. So I
watched.
Randy
Santana.
Oh, you fucker.
What's up, Randy?
How you doing?
How you doing, man?
Nice to meet you.
You too.
What's your name?
Oh, you read it.
Jared, oh yeah.
Yeah,
okay, cool.
Jared.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Nice.
So you noticed my little.
Yeah. I've seen that before.
How you been, bro?
Good, not too bad.
So I saw like so many of your reviews since you started out, like very little subscribers, man.
Oh, cool. Awesome. Okay, cool. Well, no, I appreciate you.
You started off as a construction worker.
Construction
right?
management. Yeah.
And then you're like, man, I just wanted to pursue my dream.
Well, yeah. So it's either travel around and go do some, or quit. So,
yeah, exactly. And I know that one of the keys to success is persistence. Like, never give up. Like,
yeah.
A lot of people tell me too. Like, hey, why are you doing YouTube? You know what I'm saying? Like, YouTube is like, it's not gonna like just online all day. And you're not doing anything. Like, you're playing video games or whatever.
Such a pleasure finding you.
I put like, cause I'm so random.
A long time, man. Cause
I'm so random. Like, I'll just put like videos or whatever because I just want like a ton of content. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm just like, I like putting everything I can on there.
Oh, good.
That's just me. Like, I was like so random, but like, you know what I'm saying?
Where are you from?
Houston.
Houston, okay.
So I just drove like that.
I got on the Price is Right?
Yeah, I was on the Price is Right.
Really? No shit.
It came out on the 20th.
Very cool.
Okay. I love the pizza.
Did you win?
I won a shirt from a dance contest.
Like, okay.
I used to break dance, but I weigh like 240 pounds right now, so it's really hard.
Oh,
like, still,
yeah, I bet.
Still really flexible, so
okay.
I beat these like old ladies, you know.
Really? Like, okay.
Just swimming or whatever.
But nice.
It was really fun. But yeah, what you up to, man?
Oh, not too much. This guy.
Boogie Train 8, that's the first time I met him.
Yeah.
Who's that?
That's what I'm trying to find out. Right?
But I know he's, because he was really, I think, obviously he knew who he was. I still haven't seen Dane. Dane's over there. I still haven't said hi. Oh, can I get a picture with you from Instagram?
Of course, yeah.
Okay. Let me turn this off.
Yeah, you go. I heard
an hour and a half to the one airport, which was, I don't remember, because I had a joint beforehand. And on the other flight, brought me to Houston.
Oh, nice.
An hour and a half, so.
And then you got picked up from there?
Yep.
Oh, well, good, good.
And that limo driver gave me the other joint.
Hey, there you go.
Can I take a picture of you?
Yeah, man.
Okay, I'm taking a picture of him, and then you, or we could do one, like, together. Like, it sounds weird, but
we could. Oh, that's
cool, man. Okay, let me, who's going to take the picture? Maybe we get Boogie Train 8, and I want a picture with him.
That's what I was going to say. I didn't know what to expect that day when he might have been a cleaner.
Here, bro?
Yeah.
I'm good, man. This is a legend.
You're a legend. I'm looking
down, man. I'm looking down these streets, baby.
Look. You're a little guy right now, but look.
1228? What's next? This is 1228. What's next?
We're getting the sound momentarily.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
The creators of CraveCon. Right here. Like right now, you see, okay, maybe there's like a little bit of people. Maybe, you know, we got. No, man, this is going to be like VidCon. You know what I'm saying? It's going to be like VidCon. Like bigger than that. You know what I'm saying? This is as big as you want to make it. You know what I'm saying?
Look, we have the whole convention center. Right now, we are only in but the top floor in two rooms. We didn't even branch out of this yet. We didn't even take this thing downstairs yet. We are at the very beginning, and I love everybody that came through. And just when everybody said nobody was going to come through because it was in Texas and it wasn't in LA or it wasn't in New York, Texas came out to show that love. Texas came out to show that love, and I appreciate every last individual that made CraveCon possible.
Yeah, and I like how you said the long way. You know, like that food company. Mm-hmm. No one reached out to you.
Yeah,
food company.
Nobody. Checkers is on.
You know what I'm saying? And nobody was. I was. promoting it too, like, hey, everybody go to KubeCon, you know, for days and days and days before the, when I first heard about it. And because I knew, like, this is my field. I've never been to any con before.
Wow.
This is the first con.
Wow.
And I'm only going to come to KubeCon.
Yo, you see how real that is?
Right there, the long way. The long way.
Right there. That's an individual believing in something long before it had a chance to be anything. This is KubeCon alumni you're looking at right here. Big J's in the building, rocking with your main man, Zane Drops. Big things are happening. Alright? Pay attention to these faces. You're going to see them again next year. It's going to get a little more crazier next year. But no, we're here right now. We're starting with that seed.
That seed.
We're starting with that seed. That's all we need, baby. That's all we need.
We're gonna plant. We're going to cultivate. Yes, we're going to sunlight. We're going to grow. Sir. We're gonna make more seeds. Trust me.
They ain't ready for you, man.
You think somebody psyched you, you know what I'm saying? But like, I swear though, like I can see the future. Like, you know what I'm saying? This is gonna be so big, man. And you're gonna be the creator, man. The biggest things that a person can do is leave a mark on the earth, on the planet. And that's what he's doing, man. That's the biggest, you know what I'm saying? Like, people you think of, people that people forget, didn't leave a mark. Jesus, Gandhi, Teresa, like creators of anything. That's what we are. We're creators, man. We envision, and then we see things like you know how the creators, like Beyonce or someone, like mm-hmm. singer. They say, I saw the stage
so, in my before head it
before it happened. And then exactly when I got there, it was just as I saw it. This is the same thing. And I can see it. And I can see it. And I know you can.
And you know,
we're talking.
You know, I had that vision, but I never put anything out there into the world to ever make an individual feel as if it's something that they can't do. You know what I'm saying? When I talk to remind you that every single last one of you can make this happen. You don't have to be a certain person. You don't have to have a certain type of money in this. Well, you have to believe in yourself.
Yeah.
This is us believing in ourselves from day one, knowing the fact that we're going to see tomorrow and make this bigger. YouTube didn't give us a food category. I asked. YouTube didn't give us a food con. I asked.
Yes, I know.
But I got tired of asking, and I started doing it.
Yeah.
You put your first foot forward. Blah, that first step. You start here. If you do not step out, you won't find what it is that you're looking for. You got to step out and believe in yourself on that first step, or you will fall.
Persistence.
That first step, you have to believe in yourself.
Faith. Yeah, the keys. I got the keys. That's one of the keys, man. If you got faith, persistence, endurance, you know, all that stuff. There's a story, man, and I read it in a book, but you hear it in a lot of different forms.
Mm-hmm.
It's called 3 Feet from Gold, man.
Right.
These guys, they went out and they bought all this equipment to mine gold.
Mm-hmm.
These people, right? And they were digging and digging for 3 months,
yeah.
And they quit. And they left all their equipment there. The villagers went up,
yeah.
And they dig for 3 feet, and they had millions of dollars of gold.
Woo!
And they just went that much farther.
Uh-huh.
They got it. Man,
okay, we actually got to continue on with the show.
All right, all right.
Oh, I'm getting so super myself.
Yeah, I know.
I thought the temper tantrum that you were throwing, I knew you were exaggerating. Like I thought, but I thought you really sounded like that and talked like that.
Well, what can I say, man? I'm like a fucking fury at him. Like video games are fucking terrible, man. I can't fucking kill this. What is this camera doing in my face?
Fuck
the fuck out of my face! God damn it! Oh my god, you fuckers! Get your cameras! I'm trying. I'm out of here. Fuck this. I'm out of here.
I got
a Francis moment.
I got a Francis moment on my channel too.
Awesome.
This is going to be epic, bro. I'm telling you, like that picture she took. With everybody, the more people you get that have any kind of power, star power and things that we have, it grows, man. It's going to be so big. It's going to be so big.
Cool.
Okay, come on.
I'm about to bring you out. Right, Randy, out already. Bring you out with.
Bring you on this.
What the fuck? I'm playing Pokemon Go here. Do it.
So when I come up to put you on the phone, it's gonna be like turn off like this off. If it's natural, like
how short we got in the session? It's like ten seconds. Okay.
Snapchat, so I'm just gonna put you on the news. I'm just gonna put you on the news.
Alright, you got it.
Yeah, I want to take a picture with you, but I need someone to take a picture with. Like someone to take a picture.
Let's do this.
Oh, I'm sorry. You didn't.
Put your own news.
Oh, don't put me on a fucking news. Put your ass on a fucking news. Get that camera out of my fucking face.
Hi, everybody.
Hi.
How are we doing our
thing? Alright, peep this out.
Yes.
How you doing?
You doing? Good to meet you.
Oh, Jeff, look at this.
Yeah.
You commented on my stuff. I've seen your
stuff.
I'll give you one of my cards without a doubt. For you.
Oh, okay. You look at that, guys.
Official.
I'll give you one of my cards.
Please.
Well, I got like one hand.
It's fantastic to meet you. Absolutely.
But yeah, I love your channel, man. I mean, it's like awesome stuff. It's really like crisp, like the opposite of my channel. You know what I'm saying? Your channel, like exact opposite of mine, as far as like organization. Yeah. Like your channel is so organized, like I like it. Like when you open the food, it's like you're like a blowing game.
That's the whole thing about keeping it out of close. I like showing the food in detail and really getting it in there, without a doubt.
So I love your channel, man.
Thank you.
Like I said, it's the most organized out of all of the food channels. I think this is don't tell anybody.
No. I appreciate that.
It is.
Attention to detail. That's what it's all about.
Yeah.
Jared, this is great to meet you, man, for sure.
So how have you been?
Good.
How are you doing?
Good. We're having such a blast at CreativeCon right now. I got to tell you, for me and me to be amongst all the foodies and all the big, larger-than-life personalities here right now, it's utterly fantastic.
Oh,
and to
I love
meet
it.
Everyone who makes it possible, for me to do what I do that really interacts, like this guy who's filming this right now, in effect, could be my brother right here and indirectly there. Looks kind of similar, right?
Rob from Adam.
That's it.
I'll go all the way back. We're related somewhere, like the people. It's really funny to me because, like, the people when they did the when they send in the blood and they see like the different races they have in their blood.
See who you're related to and everything.
Oh, what is that called? I totally forgot what it's called.
Like an ancestry type of thing.
Ancestry.com.
Way back.
Yes, ancestry.com. And it was so surprising to me because they were surprised, like crying, that they had so many different bloodlines, you know what I'm saying? And to me, like, how would you not know that if we are
a melting pot of all kinds of races, white, Asian, Hispanic, whatever it is. You know, that's why it blows me away when people actually, like, hate on others like that. But I say, dude, we
all
bleed the same color.
Exactly. That boils down to individual basis. Like,
right.
There's individuals that are so good and there's individuals that are bad.
Right.
So if one individual from a race does something bad, they're not all bad.
No.
It's just the individual.
Every race has their bad apples. It doesn't matter who you are.
Exactly. And every religion has their bad apples, too.
Exactly.
Every group.
But the thing is, it takes more energy not to be nice to people than it does to be nice to people.
Exactly.
So.
There's a saying in Spanish that goes, bro. I'm sorry. Yeah, the thing is, I talked to some creators, but I got it on video too, so it's gonna be on my channel. But yeah, there's Boogies and other people signed it too.
Okay, do you
have my pen? Did you get Peep This Out to sign it?
No, I didn't.
He's right there. Peep This Out. I'm looking for the pen. Hey, do you have a pen, a marker by any chance? Could you sign this for my subscriber? His name is Kyle. He's really cool, man. Like, he comments on every one of my videos.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
I gotta get you down.
He's awesome. Okay, yeah, I have no idea. I think Boogie has. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to.
No.
It's because he gave me the thing to have them sign, like Boogie and stuff. So I was like, yeah, and then I was trying to take pictures of people.
You are a celebrity too.
Hey, I'm just a human, but I try, you know, I'm trying to go up, you know. So
we're all trying.
I looked at yours and everybody in here's socialblade.com.
Yeah.
And since 2013, we're all going up.
Dude, I just had a million channel views a few days ago. And 3 years, it's my 3-year anniversary on Monday. So it's a crazy feeling, man. If even like a few people watch this stuff,
it's like, wow, it makes you want to do more.
Yeah.
It makes you want to do more.
Growing and everything like that. like that. Just stay true to yourself, man. Like we were saying out there. Just make content that you want.
Yeah.
And people honestly will follow you if you've got something that a little bit of interest to keep moving on.
Exactly. I love YouTube, man. I love YouTube. I love certain companies like Walmart. I don't know. I just like, I love Walmart. I don't know why. I love YouTube. Google.
Yeah.
And they're creating opportunities for people like us that had in the past, like, no.
It's a platform that gives you the voice to kind of get you
out. In the past, this wasn't, it wouldn't have been in existence. And we lived like maybe a decade, a couple decades back.
Yeah. I agree.
We wouldn't have this. You know what I'm saying?
Technology,
and now that we do.
Do.
Yeah, technology is changing the world. Like, if you don't do technology, you're going to be left behind.
I agree.
Okay.
You can't evolve with it either. You got to evolve with it. You can start your channel off, but
you have to move with it.
Changes.
Yeah. There's an old saying that goes, you need money to make money. Have you heard that saying?
No.
But, yeah, there's an old saying, you need money to make money. That's not true with the internet. Okay, let's say I was homeless, right? Okay, check this out. This is a free phone from the government, right? If I was homeless and I go to a public library, right, and I upload these videos on the computer, I can monetize and I get paid. Residual income is the highest form of income. Residual passive and royalty income are the highest form because no matter what you're doing, it's always coming back. Always coming back.
And channel views and everything too.
Views and then another website, kdp.amazon.com. You write books and you do the books through Amazon, and then they publish it for free. You don't need a marketing, you don't need an agent. They market it for you.
Yeah.
It's all free. And you don't need any money to do that. I don't even need a camera to do that. I just go to a library and need a Word document and then just publish it.
So 9 times out of 10, you don't need money to make money. But it's good to have a little bit of money.
Oh, of course.
For some production.
Of course.
But naturally, yeah. It's very, very, very true. It's very,
of course. Very true. Okay, guys. Please like, subscribe. Make sure you... give shout outs and also share, like, subscribe to his channel. Definitely. Keep this out.
Appreciate that very much. Stay frosty as always.
Yeah. He's out.
How is it living without hair?
Yo.
Boom, boom.
Love dying. Punch that.
Punch it. See, Jared, we know.
We know what's up.
We know what's up.
So I'm here with Peep This Out and Rob Dyke, man. We're here at CaveCon 2016. And you know what is good?
You know healthy junk food?
That's healthy junk food? Yeah. I'm so sorry. Like,
I always do an awkward handshake. So.
Oh, yeah. I'm too. Yeah. Like,
let's just do that. Okay. Yep. And then like,
A little bit of that. That was like a pinky promise at the end. Like, that was funny.
You liking CraveCon?
Yeah, man. It's really awesome. And I'm actually kind of glad that there's nobody here, because then now look,
right.
Like I have everybody to myself.
That's super intimate, you know.
No, my channel look.
Super chill.
Okay, I was telling Ken a little while ago, because you know how Ellen DeGeneres was at the Grammys and she took a picture with everybody?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If we can get like everybody together and we do like something like a video or a food review, that would get like a lot of views.
I think you'd have to ask Dane.
Yeah.
But wouldn't that be
like
cool?
A coordinated event where everyone is just
We're all together, like in a line or something, and we're like, hey, and we jolly jump or a right. picture or something, and then that would be
Dane.
Like
Dane could organize. Like, I can't. Dane.
Yeah, I'll definitely ask him, but I think that, like a vision that I have, so I think that would be really cool.
Yeah.
And we could put that as a picture for the next CraveCon 2017.
Hell yeah.
There's going to be a lot of fun videos and pictures coming out. There's already a ton on social media right now. There's just a lot.
Oh, yeah, I've been doing it every day, like CraveCon.
Oh, yeah, straight up.
When I put on Twitter, I go to the website, so I'm like, so I would just put them out like all the time.
No, it's fantastic. Just the ability to have you guys back over here and interact, that's what makes it. Really, just talking to you directly. Mano y mano.
Yeah.
And these guys come on.
Yeah, I'm sorry, like, it might be awkward, like, because I know you guys do, like, a lot. Like, when I record, for me, I record, like, anything, anytime. Like, just it might be weird sometimes, because I record wherever I'm at, you know what I'm saying? Like, whatever I'm doing, like, because, like, I know sometimes, like, at first, like, I didn't know what to record at first, so I would just do eating videos, because I didn't know what to record. But now, like, you can record anything. It's just content. You know what I'm saying? There's all different kind of people that watch all different kind of stuff.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Hell yeah.
But yeah, so just be careful with me. Like, I think about...
Don't say some weird stuff.
I don't even curse on my channel. Because I'll be seeing it and be like... You know what I'm saying? I'm weird like that. All right, guys. Please like, subscribe.
Please like, subscribe. Healthy Junk Food, Rob Dyke, and Peter's out.
Yes.
And of course, YouTube, Jared. Okay, yeah, I got Randy Santel. Okay, so I'm just waiting for, what's his face? Yeah, Santoro. All right, guys.
Get the question.
Oh, the question. Yeah. Does anything grow in your hair? How does it feel like not having hair?
How does it feel to live as a bald man? Yeah, I have to say it's from me.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. He doesn't believe me.
Yeah.
If he doesn't believe me, I got it right here.
And I'm at the food convention here. Okay. All right.
Oh, no, he's funny.
Guys got me motivated. Down to the start of tomorrow. Maybe even tonight, okay?
Got a question over here.
Hey, Ed, have you ever found Timmy the squirrel? You ever find Timmy, your lost squirrel?
Oh, my pet squirrel, Timmy? You heard about that. Yeah, I had a pet squirrel. And me and my wife got it. She yelled at him. She shooed him away with the newspaper. And he got all there and hit his elbow. He got mad. And we think that's why he ran away. So I was going around asking people if they found Timmy. And that's what he knew about it. Because he lived in the same town. But he probably heard about it. Anyway, no, we didn't find Timmy. I think he got run over, to be honest with you.
Okay. If there is one creator that you would collab with, who would that creator be?
Oh, anybody. I'd love to eat some with you, man. When are we going to get in that Bentley? Let's do this. Like, let's go destroy some seafood place. I always worry about eating on camera. Because like the other night, I ate a banana on social streaming on Twitch, and that got real sexy. Real fast.
Did the donations just said?
Oh yeah, it was bad, man. They were like, take it all, take that whole banana, get your potassium, boy. Oh, weird. But, I don't know, man. I think I've met probably 200 or 300 YouTubers, all the way from just starting out to top of the list, you know. Markiplier, Jack, because if I can say something, I've never met a YouTuber I didn't like. I'll collab with you all.
Yeah, go booty!
I haven't
collabed with you anyway. Ruined my reputation.
Love you.
Love you too, babe.
Okay, let's go over here.
Okay, this one's for Boogie. Like, when does Francis decide to come out?
Oh, well, you know, okay, so I've talked about this a couple times. I've never really talked about it on YouTube, but I have some real anger issues, like, as a person. But for the most part, I've managed to kind of learn to keep that out of my daily life. Francis is absurdly cathartic, because I just finally get to let some of that poison out of my brain, and it's a very toxic place. So, I try to do them at least once a week just to help keep my sanity. If you ever watch my live streams, though, you'll know where the Francis comes from, because I will be doing the shtick but not the voice, because I'm genuinely mad. Like, I can't believe this game is fucking broken. Why does this happen? The only thing that's missing is this. It's just part of who I am, and I love that part of me. But Boogie's kind of a character. The Boogie character you see on YouTube is, I mean, that's like the version of me I want to be. Francis is the version of me I don't want to be. And the character you see on live stream is unfortunately me. If you've ever seen one of my live streams, I'm sorry. I did not mean to do that to you. But I am broken from the inside out. So, yeah, it's cathartic. I try to make it happen at least once a week just to stay sane. And it helps a little bit.
Any more questions out there, ladies and gentlemen? I mean, feel free to ask them now. I've got these individuals before you.
Got another one over here.
Okay, back to Ed Bassmaster. Man, what character is going to come out in your next video out of your
month? I'm making another video. First kind of question, is Crave gone on Instagram?
Yeah.
Cool.
Crab Con or Crave Con? Crab. Use the hashtag Crave Con TX for Crave Con.
Well, my battery died, never mind. Anyway. What were you saying again? I'm sorry. Wait, when are better characters? No. Do you, that's the answer.
Do you believe you'll ever find Timmy?
Yeah, at the time. No, I think you honestly got
me. Oh, I did.
Because what happened was when I went out on the the four wheeler.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
There was a squirrel that was smashed on the side of the road that went there before.
And yeah.
One of my neighbors, I told him, I said he carried, because he took out, we got a.
He had a knapsack.
Knapsack for, because he likes to play hiking or camping.
Yeah,
or
he do that.
My wife would like to do imaginary pictures and stuff like that with this squirrel. Like,
yeah.
Do a little photo shoot with it, you know what I mean? So when I went out and I seen the squirrel smashed, same size as Timmy and everything, but he didn't have his knapsack, so my wife don't think that's him, but I think that somebody found the knapsack and took it.
When you talked to Dana White from UFC, like how did that conversation go with
you? Well, my interview was I do a lot of news. Put people on the news and get footage. Can you say shit? Do a lot of interviews and shit like that. So yeah. Dana White, you know, he respects that, you know, I didn't get the story, I go out and get it. That's why I came to CramCon to get the
Okay, one more question for Boogie about VidCon. You had lost your channel for a few moments there. What was your exact feelings at that time?
Oh man, I thought everything was over forever, and I just about walked out the window of a hotel on the 12th floor. I was like, I panicked. But my first thought was, oh my God, how could this be happening while I'm at VidCon? And then my second thought was, oh boy, this is happening while I'm at VidCon. If I want to find a Google engineer, there's like 30 here. And so that morning, I had a panel to do, and I had to sit there with my anxiety just flaring, like, well, what do you think about fair use? And I walked out of my panel, and one of the folks from the Princess Rap Battles channel, he's like, hey, I found a Google engineer. Do you want to meet him? Absolutely. And I sat there with the nicest gentleman by the name of Jeff, and he genuinely saved my career, he saved my life, he saved everything. He just taught me how to work my security a little bit better. We figured out how he got in, he figured out what he did while he was there. It was amazing. But I thought the world was over. And I've always been waiting for that. Like, my anxiety disorder has always said, hey, this is all going to crumble one day. I'm like, today was the day. And you know what? It's kind of nice. It's just the apocalypse isn't as bad as they made it up. Also, by the way, just real quick, I know you guys really like Instagram. I just want to make sure you guys know I'm not on Instagram. I've never made an account. I downloaded it, but I thought it was Instaham, a ham delivery service.
Instaham.
And it wasn't, so I uninstalled that. But if you guys know where to get him, okay, all right. But yeah, but thanks to Jeff. Number one, thanks to everybody who made it very vocal that that had happened, and thank you to like Jeff.
For the burger. Yo, yo, what a dude. Oh, look at that. Oh, look at the boat thing, man.
Yeah.
It goes in the water and the land.
So he found you?
Yeah, he found me. He's Tri-Squad.
They're all Tri-Squad?
Yeah, and then he introduced me to Kyle, the one that got my number somehow. The one with the red hat. I don't know. They had like one video each.
Entrees and
55,
made just for you.
Thank you.
55 and older.
That's me.
Hello.
Hello, how are you doing? Good. How you doing? What's your name?
Azari.
I'm Jared. How you doing, man?
What would you like to
do? I don't know yet. I'll just get water.
Can I get a Diet Coke?
No.
Diet Pepsi.
Like
a water.
No water, no ice.
Look at my hat, bro.
Yeah, we're gonna have these guys.
Okay. Diet Pepsi's fine, right?
Yeah.
Okay, two checks. So it's
been. Yeah, it's me, him, and his sister over there.
Yeah.
Me and Jason. Okay?
Yeah. Alright, yes sir.
Do you want your camera?
Huh? Yeah, yeah.
How
are
you
going to
eat all that really cool?
I don't know.
Man, I want to take this green stuff out of my hair. You know, I've never eaten. I've been in Houston 3 years and I've still never eaten at Rainforest Cafe.
How you doing, Scott?
It's good.
I mean, how you doing,
okay.
Scott?
It's expensive.
Pretty food. Good. How you doing, Lex?
Yeah. It's like the one in the mall.
What's cool is while you're here,
yeah.
Even if you don't eat there. This is our one. They got that little river ride. It's kind of cool.
Oh, they do?
Yeah. It's,
oh,
wow. Yeah, you go.
You get wet on it.
You go in a cave.
Oh, here, Rainforest.
Yeah, it's kind of neat.
The one in the Galleria. The reason I don't like it is because. Even if you clean, like all the stuff on the ceiling, all that doesn't
they have a river
accumulation.
Thing?
I'm sorry?
Is that at a Rainforest Cafe?
Yeah, the one
yeah,
in the Galleria.
One
in the Galleria. But there's so much stuff on the ceiling, like all the dust and stuff.
By the ice skating rink.
And everything's moving too, like.
Do they have animals in there? I've never been to
They're one. Not real animals.
But they don't have any real animals?
No,
like
why?
Snakes?
Why would they have real animals?
In a cage? I think,
okay, like,
I think it's about to run out of battery.
Because even
oh, yeah.
Generous has.
Ask him about the charger.
Oh, yeah. Dad, do you have your charger yet?
Yeah, give me like 1 second. Yeah. And then we'll find out. Yeah.
I don't remember how to play. It's been so long since.
We'll do what you were just doing right now. It sounded cool. Oh.
Oh God, it's been so
it's
long.
It's so cool.
So long.
And putting it on the news thing, and then I got to meet Boogie today, who I was able to during lunch. I gave him some carrots. He wasn't too happy, but now let's eat some donuts. All right, 1, 2, 3, boom.
Push it into your face!
Go, Randy! Randy Santillo!
Randy!
Randy! Randy! Randy! Randy! Randy! Randy! Randy! Randy! Randy! Randy! Randy!
Randy!
Randy!
Randy! Randy! Randy! Randy! Randy! Randy! Randy! Randy! Randy! Randy!
Randy, you should listen to some music while he's doing this. So
oh, yeah, he do.
It helps him with special songs and verses. He'll tell you when he's finished eating.
Usually he listens to
metal.
Taylor Swift. I know,
yeah,
I know he listens to Taylor Swift. Party in the USA, that's it.
I don't know any of her.
Party in the USA.
Party in the USA.
I
like the one she sings about the roses. Where the roses was. That when I die, put me in a roses throne. I like that one. I love that song.
Hurry up, because dinner's coming up. It's served before dinner.
Yo, tri-squad. Tri-squad, come in over here. Tri-squad. That wasn't me, bro.
What is he doing?
That was Jerry.
Yeah!
One more bite!
Thank you
yes.
for watching all those as well.
Hey,
thanks for watching.
Let's give it up for Randy Jordan.
Yeah! Randy! Best!
Personally, I would like to thank every last individual that we have before us right now for coming through to CraveCon 2016. Again, we start everything off ever so small because right now this is a family environment right here. And I want you to know that I appreciate every last one of you for coming far and wide just to be here today. This is CraveCon alumni that we are all looking at right now. I'm going to start down here with Healthy Junk Food. Just real quick, I want you to give your channels a shout out all the way straight down to Morrison. We'll start with you. Let them know where to find you on YouTube. Work it out.
Guys, if you don't already know Healthy Junk Food, we are Healthy Junk Food at everything. At Healthy Junk Food Twitter, at Healthy Junk Food Instagram, Healthy Junk Food page, and we really appreciate your guys' support and coming here. And honestly, here's your chance tonight. If you guys are going to be around, come up to us and request what you want us to make next. We probably won't make it, but we will take the consideration of doing it. You know, you never know. And that's what we really want to do.
Hey guys, you can find me at www.trollu.virus.creditcardinfo.web. For those of you who don't know me, I have a YouTube for Boogie2988.
Yeah!
Being on YouTube, but then again, I'm pretty big wherever I am. I talk about video games, talk about life. I got my character Francis. If you've ever seen one of my videos,
it's probably me talking with a list, getting stuck with an astronaut.
Last week at twitch.tv/Boogie2988. Come check me out. And that's pretty much it. But don't pay attention. These guys are the real talent. I just break stuff. Check these people out, way more important to me. I just fuck around, man. I'm small.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Loki Molasses. You can see me on Cold New.
Vomit.com.
Yes, yes. You'll see me projectile vomiting every time. Almost every time.
maybe. And I also have a Twitch channel on the side, and I also make my own comic on my own channel, on YouTube. So, talk on by.
Get comfy.
Here's my thing.
Senior World, Cold Moon. Catch me, see, my Twitter and Instagram is Senior World. YouTube/Cold Moon?
As you already know.
I don't know how to use microphones, apparently. It's all good. All right, I'm going to pass it down to
Hey guys, I'm Ian Kay from Peep This Out. It can be found at youtube.com/peepthisout, as well as on Twitter, Instagram, Peep This Out Reviews. Actually, I'm also on my own website at peepthisoutreviews.com as well. A lot of crazy food review stuff, but a little bit of pop that I like to do there. So without further ado, I'm going to pass this on over. Stay frosty, and thanks for coming out. Give yourselves a round of applause right now for being here with us.
Yeah.
We all greatly appreciate it, greatly, from the bottom of our heart. Thank you.
Eric Pink from Cold Moo. They have this fantastic new invention called Google. Just type in Cold Moo. You'll find everything. Thank you.
Yeah, I like you. Matt Zion from Reckless Eating with Chris Reckless and Dev Cole. Just Reckless Eating, you can find it. It's good stuff. By the way, I like you a lot too.
Thanks, man.
Thanks. Hey, you already know or don't know that my videos are up online at Ed Bassmaster's YouTube channel. And thanks for coming out and spread the word to help find Timmy.
Yeah!
I'm Eric from ErikTV365. We do family vlogs. We've been doing it for over 6 years. We're in our seventh year. We do a lot of
And fun. I've known him for 5 years, so I know he's not lying.
I feel like that's all I need to say right there.
Hey everybody, thanks for coming. Randy Santel, everything.
Randy! Randy!
Facebook, everything, YouTube, everything's Randy Santel. There's only one. If there is a second, a couple days after I find out.
There's a little one right here. One.
So thanks for watching any videos that you do. And if you've ever wanted to try a food challenge or to find a food challenge, there's an awesome website that I know of called foodchallenges.com.
Yeah.
Any tip you could want, anything like that. You'll be able to find it there, and wherever city you're in, just put in your zip code into our map, and you'll find out all the ones as well. So, thank you guys for coming.
Yes, sir.
Chris, can you talk?
Yeah. Somebody get a picture of Boogie's plane.
It is, but it's really low. Put some creamer.
So what's up, guys? YouTube, Jared here. I'm here with my main man, Santoro here.
What's up,
man, bro?
Man, I'm good, man. You know. Look like you're energized, ready for crazy. I'm ready to eat some good food tonight with my main man, Dane Drops, Robbie Dickles, a.k.a. Dick Trickles, a.k.a. Rob Dyke, and all these beautiful people. It's going to be a good night.
Yeah,
appreciate
you
coming, man. Appreciate that.
Awesome,
good seeing you, man.
Have a good night.
Yeah, yes,
sir.
Absolutely.
This is
what's up. Cool, man.
In 2013.
Look, Randy's watching Boogie tonight, 8-8. The Pokemon on.
Thanks.
And now the Browns will friend. Lamp barn.
Jeter.
I gotta pee.
Okay.
Right here?
How about right here?
You
got you ready?
Yeah. Sorry about.
Here we go.
He's about. Oh, okay. Nothing happened.
Oh, it's cute. It's pink.
He doesn't mind.
All right. By the laws of the South, you're officially my property now.
Awesome. What? You have to take off. Be careful.
It's been a pleasure, man. So much fun hanging out with you, dude. We had dinner together, made out in the bathroom.
Yeah.
some, man.
But that's for other.
That's for the underground website. Jared, you can't just take
stuff. I mean, borrow it.
Oh, no.
Oh, hell.
Oh, hell.
Oh, you know my one weakness, moving slightly faster than this chair.
You figured it out. Are you sure you got it? Are you sure you got it? Yeah. How come it says 13 seconds? How come it says 13 seconds?
I got two because then I stopped.
And you stopped? Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry for interrupting.
Oh, no. You're awesome.
I'm like, I know I flushed up here.
This one's on the red light. Oh, it turned off right now.
Oh, yeah, right now I'm.
No, this one, the other one. It has a red light on.
Oh, yeah, shit.
He's touchy feeling.
All right, don't worry.
I wish I had a Sharpie to do this. It would be really awesome. I could hang it on my.
Someone might have one in there. It's running to go.
I had
one. You got a Sharpie!
He was a YouTuber first.
Yeah, I wrote that.
I have a notebook in here somewhere.
I was a YouTuber before all you people. I was a YouTuber before he was a twinkle in his daddy's eye.
I was a YouTuber before YouTube was invented.
Yeah.
Hold this. I'm gonna give you my notebook.
What if I give this to Boogie?
If you want to.
Boogie, if I give this to you, give me a shout out and put it in your room.
I already gave you a shout out today, didn't I?
Yeah,
you did.
I tweeted you out, didn't I?
No.
I thought I did.
When
no,
did
I
didn't. For your
we'll
life.
Do it right now, man.
Oh, are you serious?
Do it right now. Shit.
Okay, this is for you.
That's,
what is? It's a burger suit costume.
Oh, that's fucking awesome.
I have a pizza. Do you have a pizza? I want to get my pizza one, too.
Hey, Des, will you wear that if we get that? Will you
it's
wear
a good
that
Halloween
me?
Costume, too.
I don't want to lose that.
It was also on... it was also on Let's Make a Deal.
I'm doing a dance for you, Boogie.
Give it to me. She's like, please, that's enough.
You need to like, record
that's
me.
That's going to be useful.
Record
later.
Me doing the dance for Boogie.
Give it to them. That's...
YouTube Jared, right?
Yeah.
Find you real quick. How do you spell Jared? Oh, right there on your shirt.
I'll get it from this angle.
There you are.
Yeah.
I'm looking at that logo anyway.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Which video? What's your best video?
Anyone you want. I don't know.
He doesn't have a best one, per se.
I believe in your power of judgment.
Well, the problem is I ain't got enough time to watch them all.
If that happens to be a
Frank cuts my hair.
Game show by chance?
Yeah, this is from Let's Make a Deal, Wayne Brady.
Oh, yeah.
We came out 3 weeks ago.
Oh, wow.
I was actually that burger. He
was
the pizza.
Oh, yeah. Pizza. I was like...
We didn't win anything, though. We almost did. We could have.
Yeah, I know sometimes like the one way you'll do some of this random stuff in your purse.
Yeah, we didn't even get to do that. I didn't have any of the stuff anyway in my bag.
Some of the stuff is so obscure.
Yeah, it was like a I think when we went, it was a toothpick.
Yes.
Like a certain brand of credit card. And I forget, it was something else really, really random. Like, a safety pin. Yeah, so I was like, oh. I don't have any. But they posted on Twitter before,
oh, well, yeah.
So you can know exactly what to bring. Random, yeah.
But I mean, honestly, it'll be a couple hundred.
But since I was telling him, I was like, dude, be sure you tell me beforehand, because we're flying from Texas to LA, so I'm like, what is the odds I'm going to have that shit in my bag?
Who cares about the ones that don't? Focus on the ones that do, right?
Yeah.
That's all that matters.
The ones that don't, the ones with.
Right, exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
I can't find my notebook.
But yeah, I'm giving it to you either way, bro.
Oh, well, I won't.
You want me to give it to her?
We should, no, Jared, you should mail them the pizza one.
Yeah, I'm mailing you the pizza
one. You guys have a P.O. box, right?
Yes, we do.
You should ship them the pizza one.
Yeah, I'm with you. And those are both on Let's Make a Deal. It aired on the 20th of this month.
That's awesome.
That's we're both married. Married.
All right, I gave you a shout out. That's huge.
That's enough.
Thanks.
Yeah.
What do you do with the shout out on YouTube? You do
I can't because every time I do YouTube,
yeah.
Everybody's going to ask you.
I get a thousand.
Yeah.
And then they get mad because I don't do one for everybody, right?
Yeah.
And so I try not to do it. But Twitter, I can do it occasionally.
Yeah.
I've done three today.
That's awesome.
People are going to bitch, but I don't care.
I've been doing that all day.
But that alone, dude, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That'll get you a couple hundred faces.
Yeah.
You know?
All right. Thanks, man.
You guys are awesome. It was a pleasure. Thank you so much for everything, for being nice. Thank you so much. It was, no, I hope you guys will ship you the pizza one.
Dirty stuff with that.
Record it. Dude, I'm glad it's even if that comes out,
you're not even like you're recording and you're like this.
I turned it off.
No, you didn't.
Is it still recording?
Yeah, and she's like, I'm still gonna post it like that because I don't care. Yeah.
Right.
There's all different kind of people. You know what that reminds me of?
What?
There was a scary movie I saw.
Hey, you want an exclusive?
Yeah.
I want you to stand right here.
Me?
I want to show you something. Yeah. I want to hold me. Let me get
you.
Exclusive?
This is exclusive for you. No one else is going to get footage of this.
Yes, what do I do?
Put it up. Stand right there.
Okay.
I'm going to show you how to pop a wheelie in this thing. Right?
Okay, yeah.
Okay, here we go.
Oh. Oh, you said stand right here.
Here we go.
Go
ahead. Woo!
Oh, yeah.
This is a rental, man. I wish I bought this thing.
Oh,
this
yeah?
Life, bitch. See ya.
And that's a rental for real?
Dude, you should get one.
I want one.
$10 a day. Next year, you all better be on one of these.
Those are fast.
I taught you how to play.
Those are fast, man.
Yeah, something, man.
I want one too.
I'm afraid if I bought it that I'd be too dependent on it or whatever.
You're gonna like running around everywhere.
Right, yeah, I'd just leave. That's the thing, man. I would never stay at home.
Yeah, no.
If I was half robot.
So you can play Pokemon easier.
I'm jealous of Stephen Hawking for two reasons
for
now.
Real?
Why?
Number one, he's smarter than me, and then number two, he's got a cool fucking chair.
Yeah.
And he doesn't really have to talk.
Stephen Hawking has that one?
Probably
better than that. His is probably like hovers.
His connects to his mouth
Steven.
So he could talk to
him.
Yeah.
He's a fellow Steven, right? Yeah. Did you see that movie? Stephen Hawking's biopic?
No.
He's freaky, man.
Yeah.
He had like two girls at once and stuff.
Who did?
Stephen Hawking?
When
he was like standing up and walking and
when
stuff?
He was
oh.
Like, he was married to one girl and hitting another.
How did he get like that?
Muscular dystrophy.
But was he smart before or after?
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
He was already, a PhD when he started getting...
Yeah, they told him he'd never be able to talk again. Fuck you, I'll figure it out.
He didn't have a machine.
He was a hero, man.
Wow.
And he was getting girls left and right.
When he discovered the... What was it? Because it was in the movie, too. Like, he was getting his disease along the same time he discovered the... What was he famous for discovering?
He's just like black hole theory. He's like the old black hole guy.
So when he was coming out with the theory, he also got his disease. So it was like all this shit he went through.
Yep.
Depression.
Like they didn't believe him for the longest time.
Yeah. Until it actually...
Right, they're like, black holes, okay, that makes sense.
Yeah.
But he proved it, mathematically proved it.
But wasn't it years and years later when they finally...
Yeah, y'all watch the biopic, it's amazing.
I loved it. I did see it. Yeah. I loved it.
You know how have you seen
Have you seen
Ghostbusters?
Yeah, I
liked it except the one part. You know the part where they say that we only know 4% about the universe. Okay, you know how the universe is always expanding.
Right.
Which means it's infinite. Yeah.
4% is infinite.
Exactly. So yeah. You can't put a percentage on infinity. Right. So I was mad about that. I made a YouTube video about that.
Oh yeah.
And I was like, you can't do that.
Did you watch a new one?
Yeah, that was a new one.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, that was a new one.
I was starting to think, was that the first one?
No, the second one.
Oh, yeah.
I like the part where he throws the guy out the window.
Bill Murray evil on that one.
They threw him out the window.
That was disappointing because I.
The demon threw him out the window.
Yeah, that was one of the most disappointing parts.
It was.
And that's a pretty disappointing movie. So.
Yeah.
I mean, it wasn't bad.
With that part, I was just like,
yeah.
When I saw him, I was like, yes, Bill Murray.
It was really funny.
Right.
That guy, that white guy.
I liked all the cameos except Bill's.
Yeah.
Bill's kind of hurt.
Yeah. I even liked the secretary, because she was the secretary in the hotel.
Yeah,
did you get that
yeah,
one?
Awesome.
I loved it.
You know who made that movie for me?
Who?
The male.
Thor.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
The Thor guy, he was so funny. I didn't know he was that funny.
I love that movie, man. He was so funny.
Yeah.
I didn't know he was that funny. He's like knocking on the fish.
The other real good part of that movie, Kate McKinnon. With like the way she was like super crazy, super nerdy.
Oh yeah, I like that.
Oh,
she's like
so good.
Yeah.
Yeah, like she would have been a Ghostbuster. Like
I don't really
yeah,
think any of the rest
yeah,
of them were
yeah.
Ghostbuster. I loved it.
She was a
I
fucking
agree.
Ghostbuster. She was so
yeah,
good. She was
yeah.
a blonde one, right, with the short hair.
Yeah. And she I mean she could have been in the regular team.
Yeah.
Like if she'd been an OG Ghostbusters, that would have been perfect.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I love her in that movie.
And then I like the cameo of the dad, the uncle. I love the herd.
Okay, so you know one of the things I figured out? Okay, you know the universe, like, well, it's my philosophy, whatever. You know the universe is always expanding?
Yeah.
Nobody knows what's expanding onto. Okay, right. But have you seen Dragon Ball? You seen Dragon Ball, right? Like, yeah, where Majin Buu is fighting Gotenks and Trunks inside of the hyperbolic time chamber, right, and they make a hole like to get out.
Yeah.
Okay. When you have a jet that's going super, it's breaking supersonic sound.
Right.
It's boom, 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 like it starts breaking trees, glass. Like if you had one right now, it would just shatter the building, right?
Right.
That's just breaking the sound, the barrier of sound. In between, like, you know, there's different holes: wormholes, black holes, right, and right, white holes. When you go faster. Yeah.
Buttholes.
when you go faster than sound, you can create a hole. When a star implodes, it, you know how it sucks in everything?
Yeah.
Where is it going? Okay, check this out. You know how, like, okay, you know, what
it's
is that?
Being sucked into the mass.
What is it? You know that thing that's smaller than a molecule?
Oh, yeah, quark.
A quark.
Yep.
Okay, you know it goes further in than that, but we only have tools to see so far, right?
Right.
Okay, it keeps going into that thing that's in between.
You hurt my head, man. Oh, God.
No, I want to hear it.
Yeah, no, he's super
smart. Going, yeah, he's going down. I'm into this.
Like, he's
keep going.
Where you go into that place that the stars go into.
Yeah.
If you keep looking in, it goes infinitely in. And that's you go good out, it goes infinitely out. It's something in between that right, the other realm. Right. It's another realm or something. I don't know what it is.
Here's something I think about all the time.
Yeah.
So the universe is expanding, right?
Yeah.
But I can't tell. See, here's what I think.
Yeah.
The way the universe expands is there's space between every atom in my body, right? Space in between every atom of everything, right?
Right.
So, my physics teacher tried to explain something to me one day, and I don't remember what he was trying to explain, but it says, if you have the distance between two atoms, right?
Yeah.
You cut that distance in half, then you cut it in half again, then you cut it in half again, you cut it in half again, it never becomes a zero sum. An atom can never touch an atom, he said.
No.
And with the exception of a molecular bond,
right,
but a molecular bond isn't touching.
Yeah.
So the atom can never touch an atom. I don't know why that's true, but I thought about that, and here's what I figured out. When the universe expands, there's no edge of the universe.
Right.
The universe is infinite. What is expanding is the distance between every atom simultaneously. So every atom in your body is becoming more distant apart. But the thing is, it's happening to every atom around you, so you can't tell. We can't see it. We can't feel it.
Yeah.
But right now, you and I are expanding. Yeah. I mean, I'm expanding in more ways than one. But yeah, right now, you and I are expanding. The walls are expanding. The earth is expanding. The space, yeah, is expanding. The space between every molecule is expanding, but it's unnoticeable to us. And eventually, now here's the important thing, they say that every atom will be so far apart from each other that one day the universe will experience heat death, because they'll be so far apart they can't interact.
Yeah.
Think about that. Eventually the universe as it is will expand so much, and the distance between every atom will be so far apart,
yeah,
energy won't exist.
Doesn't it go through,
isn't that terrifying,
cycles?
Yeah,
but that's what they say. Like, they theorize that it might relapse, and then, right, but who knows? I mean, nobody really knows.
Yeah, you don't really know.
And we're only alive. They say that if you chart out from the beginning of the universe to now,
yeah,
if you chart that out on a calendar, then human beings came into existence on December 31st at 11:59. We have been here in a cosmic sense for less than a minute of the year that the universe is existing. So what the fuck are we supposed to figure out?
Nothing.
Right? Like,
nothing,
how are,
yeah,
we going to figure that,
exactly,
out? And then our lifetime is a
smaller 10, fraction
of that.
Yeah.
So who knows?
Like, you
know,
can't put a, like time is infinite, or what we perceive as time, right? He's right, extremely smart.
No, I know.
So
I don't know about that, but
you're compared, thanks, to average people. Come on.
Thank you.
So what I wanted to say was, in what was I saying?
You're talking about how sexy Jennifer Lopez used to be.
She's still sexy.
No, she's all right.
But I'm just, you know, I'm.
You know who Christina Hendricks is from Mad Men?
No.
Yeah, she's the hot one.
The red,
yeah,
one?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, she's, yeah, yeah, with. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Are you obsessed with?
No,
I, no, I don't even know, oh, who that, yeah, is.
No, she's always, his wife is always showing me, like, I think she's so pretty. I think she's.
Yeah, she's awesome.
Oh, I know faces.
Where's,
I'm not good with names.
Why didn't we get to meet your wife?
She doesn't like YouTube.
That's okay.
She's like, she's really like in another like place.
That's
in,
okay,
her head.
Step on her.
No, that's part of his shoe.
Oh,
I
shit.
Think.
Is it?
Yeah.
Hey, honey.
What is this?
It's part of his shoe. Don't step on it.
It's coming out.
Oh, I think she took it out. Okay,
here.
Let me see.
Well, it's not part of my shoe anymore.
the galaxy's expanding. Yeah.
Yeah, unfortunately the shoe is dying. I blew it out halfway here, but oh well.
I'm a pop willy.
That's free. Gonna take bids on this. $200. Start $200.
$200. $200.
Let's sell it on Amazon.
Amazon.
All right, turn that camera off.
So you guys, what's up? YouTube Jerry CraveCon just finished for me. Anyways, there's probably still some people at the after party. I'm done for the night. I just went to Taco Bell. I'm trying out the new, what do they call it, Deidre, this taco?
The cheesy core.
Cheesy core, yeah, burrito. No, give me my phone, dude. No, no. Give me my thing.
Have a little bit.
Stupid idiot.
I'm gonna put it in the cup a little.
So I'm gonna review this one only, and then I'm gonna eat the rest. So
Like you want booty to stab
him. Really good.
Yeah, he was crossing the line a little too much.
And then he was like, you were hitting him on the head?
I was trying to fit his head.
I could tell the Boogie looked like this fan is crossing a line and recrossing it.
He's okay. Good.
Like I could tell he's like, he was like
an
8.3. Like,
he's looking
at his wife,
because
I could see him
and
his wife. Like, Jared doesn't pick up any social cues.
He doesn't.
Any.
No, I told you that before.
Nothing. Like, maybe he picks him up, but he doesn't.
Yeah.
And so, like, I could see Jared's here, like, messing with Boogie. Like, Boogie's way over here with Jared, secluded, and he's just, like, looking at his wife, like, help me, and his wife is like,
Look
where people like him a lot. But then it's just, love him, he starts, like, you know, to them, and, like, hitting them and petting, you just, like, why would you?
I told him that before. He thinks I'm not telling you.
Because
he had like a camera there the whole time, like in his face, like in Boogie's face, like this. And then Boogie's like, hey, turn the camera off, man. Like, let's just chill. Like, because it was the after party.
Yeah.
And I was like, dude, let's just chill. But he did like Jared a lot. But there's the thing, like, people like him a lot. But then he does cross the line.
Alright guys, please like, subscribe, and please share. And this one's 8.3 in my book, thanks. So yeah, it is now the 14th of August, and we're in the hotel room. This hotel room is bigger than Randy Santel's and the Hilton next to CraveCon, but it's cheaper. But yeah, we're still on the beach. You can see a lot of the water right there. What else? Look, there's a nice little beach house right there. Oh, but I don't think this one has a swimming pool, but I have a swimming pool over there where I live, so. You know, I don't need to go. I can go swimming in the ocean right there. You can see the pyramids. You see those three pyramids right there? Those are the, I don't know what they're called. What was that?
Don't record.
What was you saying? Yeah, it was good. Like, I had a lot of fun. I'm here right now, guys, at McDonald's. I'm gonna order something. Look, I haven't had these in a long time. I just got some. I haven't had them in years. And I got some of these. Look at that, guys.
Everybody.
Oh, mom would buy them first after school?
Everybody would eat them.
I don't remember that. I'm super popular. Mira, look.
Is that a mini camera right next to the speaker, right?
Yeah, it is a little mini camera. Jeez. I haven't seen that yet, I don't think.
Why would
look, I'm recording them, recording me.
I mean, are people doing crimes right here? Or like, what?
Yeah, they're doing crimes.
Hey, good afternoon, everybody. How can I see today?
What do you want, Deidre? Like something for a dollar? Can I get a McDouble with added Big Mac sauce?
And a double Big Mac sauce?
Yeah. Do you have breakfast all day?
Yes, sir.
Awesome. Can I get a McMuffin? The dollar one?
Sausage McMuffin?
Yes, ma'am. And can I get a 2 grape jellies with that?
And also, you want what with that?
You know, just like a grape jellies.
Grape jelly?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
And you want fries? Small fries?
That'd be after you today, sir?
How much is
oatmeal? Is that how I can make for you today?
How much is oatmeal?
Pardon me, sir?
How much is the oatmeal?
$2.15.
Give me small fries.
A small fries?
Yeah.
Alright, will that be all for today?
Yes, ma'am.
Alright, so I have here a sausage McMuffin, a Douglas mixed sauce, and a small fry.
Yes,
so that's going to be $4.08 as the first one down.
All right, thank you.
My pleasure.
Zero, do you know what ketchup is in Spanish? Do you know why? Because it's ketchup, but they say ketchup, ketchup. That's the easiest one.
I just learned that like a week ago.
I've known that for like years and years and years and years. Yep. I swear.
Yep. Don't say whatever it is.
Oh no, it's WTubers, YouTube Jerry, and back home. CraveCon just got back, still super tired. I'm gonna try out this pizza here. It is the new from DiGiorno. Bold and spicy. It's new. It's not delivery, it's DiGiorno. 100% real cheese, no artificial flavors, preservative free crust. So, got some added bonuses on there. Look at that. Okay, let's go ahead and put it in the oven. Actually, it actually doesn't look that bad, guys. It does look spicier. I can see some peppers on there and some red crushed peppers as well. Let's go ahead and heat this up. Yeah, I think I'm missing a pepperoni. Okay, so I think it's usually like supposed to be like 3 to 50 around there. Yeah, it's really sliding off. See how it comes on with you. You better not drop it.
You have it on a plate?
Yeah. No, don't put it on. That's dirty. I don't want it on that. Seriously. No, that's dirty. Dude, no.
I'm picking up the plate on the corner.
I know, but no. Just use something else. Here, what about these shorts? My shorts.
That's probably dirty.
I don't care. I'm used to this. Just use it from right here and just get that from the edge. Yeah. Don't burn them, I always wear those.
Damn, it's hot. Dude, this is not something good
okay,
to do.
Okay, let me get something else. Just do it fast. You're like waiting
it's
for
heavy.
It.
It's heavy. You don't know. Here.
I do know. Let me do it. this is really thin. That's why, right?
Yeah, and that's heavy.
Ah, oh, it's hot. Okay, guys, this is how it looks. You look like crap. A few seconds. So, guys, I have the pizza right here. And I'm going to try this out. Just a bite, and then I'm going to turn it up because I'm going to enjoy this in peace. And I know this is a really long video. If you made it this far, thank you. And I just wanted you guys, if you guys share this video, that would be nice. Right, Nidra?
Don't record me.
Oh, I'm sorry. So, but yeah, please subscribe, mostly share and like, and mostly share. Anyways, I'm gonna try this pizza out right here. I didn't cut this good.
Do they give you something to mail it?
They have a fax number. Hold on. That was actually really good. I always like these random guys. That is getting a 9 in my book.
Am I in this?
No. Please, peace out, guys.
Am I in this? Don't record me.
Giant.
Ah.